Hi everyone and welcome back. We have talked basics about Redux. Now we are going to talk about React with Redux, how Redux integrates with React. You can just talk about any simple React component, how it can get the data, how it can send an action to the Redux. This is what integration is all about. Okay, so this video is important because here we are talking about the bridge library React Redux, which is helping us to get the state from Redux or trigger an action to the Redux layer. Okay, so first we will understand this with the simple diagram. This right hand side is my React. Right hand side is my Redux. I have the actions, I have the reducer, here is my reducer, and it reducer will give me the new state inside a store. And this is my React component in the blue left hand side. So on React I have a search text field, you click on submit button, I will trigger some action, then I will map that action to the Redux action that is being done with the help of this connect library. So this is the bridge which is connecting React with Redux, and here we have two helper methods: map state to props, map dispatch to props. Map state to props is helping me to get the state from Redux. Map dispatch to props is helping me to trigger the action to the Redux layer. So this is called as a connect bridge, React Redux connect bridge. It is giving me these two helper methods to get the state, and map dispatch to props will help me to trigger the action to the Redux layer. Okay, what is my action? Search data. Okay, maybe I will be passing something in the payloads. This is my action object. Okay, my initial state is items and name. You go to the reducer, reducer will just search particular action and will return the new state. Now, same thing if you try to visualize here, you will understand it. Redux is all about store. In store, we have all the reducers, action will come from UI. Based on action, we will return new state object. That new state will be available for React components to consume. Okay, so this is my React component, which is in this bottom green. Here I have a deposit 10, withdraw 10. Okay, what we are doing is from UI we are actually sending an action. Till now we were doing store.dispatch, but when we talk about React with Redux, action will be dispatched from your React component. When you click on button, when you mouse over, when you load component, some data is coming, you are searching something, some interactions you are making. In that case only you will be sending action. Action is sent. Store has a reducers. Reducers will check what need to be done for this particular synchronous or synchronous action, because Redux is purely synchronous. Don't think in terms of asynchronous. We will talk about middlewares in future, but for now we are talking about simple action, which is like 10 rupees, $10 credited, $10 debited. Okay, so your amount will increase and your store will be updated with a new state. This is what happening. Actions. This action will have an action object type and payload. This will go to a store. Store has all the reducers. A particular reducer will check, okay, if the action name is increment and the payload is this, then what need to be my new state? This new state will be populated in the store. This new state now will be available for my UI to consume. Now, subscriber for that store can be any component in the whole React tree, React component tree. Okay, and any component from the React tree can send this action, which will update the, which will return with the new state. New state will be available to all component at any level in my React component tree. This is the advantage that my child component is not dependent on parent. Parent is not dependent on grandparent to receive the data. Your individual component can go and talk to this Redux store to get the data or send the action. So you send the action, you get a new state. New state is now available to whole React component. This subscribing mechanism is happening internally because we are using library, which is React Redux. We are using connect as a middleware in our code. That will have a two helper methods: map state to props, map dispatch to props, which will help us to interact with Redux to get the state and send the action to the Redux. Okay, only two-way communication is happening, and it is all one-way data flow. Single door entry, single action is going at a one time, one action is entering, that action is updating the state, state is update, state is new state is returned, okay, state is not updated, new state is returned, that new state will be available for UI. Another action is going, it will actually return the new state again based on the previous state, and that new state is now available for UI. This flow keeps continued, and Redux, if you are using Redux dev tool, you can actually debug or you can actually time travel the Redux state which you have gone through initially. Your the account balance was $0, then $10, then $20, then $30, then the some amount is minus. Now you have $20, $10, then $0. So you can actually do the time travel debugging. You can do the debugging with the Redux dev tools, which will give you the complete timeline of your Redux state. Because Redux, these reducers are based on the pure functions returning new state every time without updating the current state. And there can be multiple reducers. We have talked only about single one or two reducers. There can be many. So you will be combining all the reducers. After combining, you will be creating the store. First of all, you will get a root reducer using combined reducer method. Pass all the reducers, you will get a root reducer. Then you will call a create store method and pass the root reducer. Now you have a store. Now, what we need to do in React code, somehow we need to provide this store to my React component so that they can access the data inside store. Okay, let's talk in terms of React code in the next video.